So now I am teaching about WSSOA, Web Services and Service Oriented Architecture. In this, I am teaching about emergence of web services. So here, in emergence of web services, so what you are doing is how the web service has been evolved. So here, emergence of web services. So in the internet, we use the process of communicating through the network channels. So through communicating through the network channels in the web, and the services which are provided to the internet is known as web services. So here, what we are doing is the communication protocol which you are using for the request that is given to the client. So to process that request, the some services are being needed to the client, and that services are being provided by the server. So this kind of process is known as web services. So here, what we are using a communication protocol. Communication protocol, right? So here, what we are using, services are being provided to the customer. So here, what we are doing, the services are being provided to the customer. So to solve this business problems, for example, so what kind of services or for what it is used? For business purpose. For business purpose, widely this web services are being used, right? So for business purpose, these web services are being used. So next, what you are saying? So here, what you are saying means in future, if you want to go to the internet and do any of those requests from the customer, so we have to use this web services. So for example, what are the web services? Like SOAP, RPC, message passing, etc. These are the examples of web services. So here, what we are doing, the next topic is the role. SOA means service oriented architecture. So SOA means service oriented architecture. So what do you mean by service oriented architecture? So this is the architecture which binds the small services which are being used for the web services, right? So this can be used as a this can be used for web services. So here, what we are doing, we are dividing large number of functions into smaller modules. So what is the definition of this? The definition of that web services or a service oriented architecture is we are dividing the number of large number of functionalities into smaller modules. So here what we are doing into smaller modules, then after this we are communicating these smaller modules with each other to process the customer request. Right? So here what we are doing, first we are dividing the large number of functionalities into smaller modules, then we are communicating these smaller modules with each other to process the request. After that we will combine these smaller modules, and process the modules into a large functionality from which the result is being taken out. Right? So this is about what is SOA, how the process will be running. So here what you mean by SOA, service oriented architecture. This can be used for web services. So here what we are doing, we are dividing large number of functionalities into smaller modules. Right? So what we are doing after dividing that into smaller modules, we are communicating this smaller modules with each other to process the customer request, right? Then afterwards what we are doing, we are combining these smaller modules and process the modules into a large functionalities from which the result is being taken out, right? So next, it is the workflow. So here what is the workflow? What we will do here, the process through which the functionalities it means that what is the workflow of SOA. So how the SOA works. So here what is the first point? The process which you are taking, that functionality are being divided. So after dividing we will communicate and then we will combine it. So this is the workflow of this, right? Communicate and combine. Next, what are the features? So features, it is being used for computing, comma, and multitasking, or multi-programming. We can call it as multi-programming. Next, here what we will see, orchestration. Next, the future is orchestration. What do you mean by orchestration? Orchestration means first we are dividing the modules and we are arranging it in a proper order. Means we are arranging it in proper order. Means in the order which the customer will be requesting the services. First, suppose the customer one has been requested a particular service, the first customer should get the box which he has been requested, right? So this is how the proper order works. Proper order means the customer, the first customer which he has been processed the request, he should get only that request. So it can be used by this orchestration. Okay, so here once again I am going through this workflow. See here, what is the workflow? The process through which the functionalities are being divided. Next, we are communicating these divided functionalities and then we are combining to get the result. This is how the workflow of the SOAE has been done. Next, what are the features? Features means it is being used for computing and multitasking. Means the for what the SOAE is being used rapidly or most frequently. So what it is being used for? Computing and multi-programming. Next, it is used for orchestration. Orchestration is nothing but, as we have discussed before, the how the SOAE works means it has been divided into smaller modules, then it will be combined. So while combining, we should combine that in a particular order itself, right? So that the result will be efficient. So to get the result efficient, the proper order is been required. So for that we are using orchestration, right? So next, in that what you are doing is, so what are the guidelines which are used? So here, what are the guidelines which are using for SOAE? So guidelines is nothing but what you are doing this guidelines means a reuse, right? Interoperability. Communication, etc. So here, what are the guidelines which you are using? The guidelines which you are using is for that problem, the service which you are going to use, it should be reused, right? The process which you are doing, that can be reused for the other services also, right? Next, interoperability. Interoperability means if you are using this web services in a particular system and if the system has been crashed in the middle of that, so that can be used for the other system also. So that is interoperability. And communication protocol. The communication protocol means some of the main features which you are getting or which you are using, or there will be some special functionalities to use that special services only. So for that special services, we have to go through this only communication protocol, right? The communication protocol is very important here in the web services. So what we are using means the communication protocol which you are using should be authenticated, right? The authenticated. So because here what we are doing, we can expose some yellow pages. So we can expose some yellow pages which are not authenticated, right? Some yellow pages are being distorted, and these yellow pages are being found by default, right? Found the fault so by using these authenticated services. And another guidelines which you are using is some encapsulation. Abstraction. So here encapsulation. So encapsulation means what we are doing. In encapsulating, what is in Java we have learned about encapsulation. Encapsulation means binding the all the small particles into one thing. So we are encapsulating these small services, because as we already discussed in this web services, what is the web services means, we are dividing the large functionalities into smaller modules. So after dividing it, we are encapsulating that these things, and then abstraction is the same thing means, while we are hiding the low content. So abstraction means we are hiding the low content, and we are just for customer purpose we are giving that an easily a page will be displayed on that thing, so that the customer will not get confused while using the service. So these are the guidelines which you are used. So next, what we are doing, we are discussing about the role of SOA, right? What is the role of SOA? So here we are mainly discussing about the role of SOA means, so we have two important roles. One is service provider, and next is service requester, customer. You can use customer. So here what you are doing is, the role of SOA, the role of service oriented architecture, is in between these two things. One is service provider and next one is service customer. Means what here does, what it does means, we can see here, service provider and next service customer. So we are sending the data, the customer will give the request. The customer will give the request, and then the service provider will give the response, right? So here what it is means, the service customer requests one of the file, or it may be any kind of service, right? A request of service. So for suppose the customer is requesting any kind of service which he want to execute to get the result, it goes to service provider. So here what that the service provider will do, he will say that whether the request is being granted or not, if the service which he is available for that. So the customer which is requesting the service provider, if it provides it, it gives the response as, you can take it for this much time, or you can take this within a particular time, or this much of amount he will be charging for that. So this kind of services can be charged, and some may be free as well. So what is this customer will do? Any minute.